Remember the night. Remember the feeling. Remember the magic in our lives. You opened up my eyes to a new world revealing. So remember the magic. Just remember.
Hi everyone, and welcome to episode 10 of Remember the Magic. In this show, we take a deep dive into everything extinct Disney. In today's episode, I will be talking about the Magic Kingdom's long-running but now defunct castle stage show, Dream Along with Mickey. Let's begin! The history of this show really begins in 2003 at Tokyo Disneyland, when two entirely new shows appeared, both of which are strangely vital to the story of this one. One of which was Cinderellabration. Looking past that terrible pun of a name, this show was a seasonal castle stage show that ran during winter between 2003 and 2008. Disney decided to clone the show and bring it to the Magic Kingdom as a more permanent addition in 2005. The second Tokyo show vital to the story was called Mickey's Gift of Dreams. This castle stage show was created for Tokyo Disneyland's 20th anniversary, and if nothing else, it had a much better name than Cinderellabration. Mickey's Gift of Dreams ran in Tokyo Disneyland between April 15th, the park's anniversary, and September 19th, 2003. After this, it was replaced by a show called Viva Magic. Fast forward a bit to 2006, when after a mixed reception, Disney decided that Cinderellabration was not suited for the Magic Kingdom, and they thus began thinking of a replacement. Also at this time, Disney was preparing to give the Magic Kingdom a new year-long festival. It's a bit hard to think about today, but between 1999 and 2010, Disney kept doing these strange year-long promotions. It all started with the Millennium Celebration in 2000. Then came the 100th Year of Magic in 2001 to celebrate what would have been Walt's 100th birthday. Then the Happiest Homecoming on Earth, which was created in order to celebrate both the departure of Paul Pressler and the 50th anniversary of the Parks and Resorts division of the company. Then in 2006 came the Year of a Million Dreams. This was not a celebration of a year or an anniversary, but rather just a massive celebration for seemingly no reason. The event centered around the Disney Dreams giveaway, in which random park guests were selected to win a multitude of prizes, ranging from a fast pass to a night stay in the Cinderella Castle suite. With the event quickly approaching, Disney began thinking of what they could do to celebrate it. For one, they would be rebranding their existing Share a Dream Come True parade into the Disney Dreams Come True parade, but I talked about that a few videos ago, so for today we'll focus on the other main addition. Dream Along with Mickey. This show is to be mainly an English translation of Tokyo's Mickey's Gift of Dreams, but it was also to feature some parts either stolen from other shows or completely new. Cinderellabration held its last performance in the Magic Kingdom on September 16th, 2006, and on September 30th, Dream Along with Mickey premiered. People really liked the new show. It was heartfelt, fun, exhilarating, and most importantly, spectacular. The show was originally slated only to run through the Year of a Million Dreams. But then that year became a year and a half, and then 2 years, and eventually 2.5 years. The Year of a Million Dreams just kept getting extended and extended, so the show just stuck around. Eventually, Disney announced that the 2.5 years of a Million Dreams would conclude on December 31st, 2008, but Dream Along with Mickey would continue in now an open-ended run. People were very happy, especially since the show now featured a fun new concept called Articulated Movements. Added in 2007, this new costume technology allows the characters to actually emote and talk rather than just shake their heads around. Sure, some people think it's creepy, but I actually like it. Personally, I think it's creepy when their mouths are just hanging open 100% of the time. Anyway, people were excited to see that the show would be continuing. It was truly beloved. Throughout the years, more and more castle shows began appearing seasonally, such as Mickey's Most Merriest Celebration and the Hocus Pocus Villain Spelltacular, many of which pay reference to Dream Along with Mickey in a multitude of ways, most notably the technology. Anyway, Dream Along with Mickey continued to run for nearly a decade without any changes, but unfortunately, all good things must come to an end. On February 15th, 2016, the Disney Parks blog announced that a new castle stage show dubbed Mickey's Royal Friendship Fair would be replacing Dream Along with Mickey that summer. People were very sad about this, since Dream Along with Mickey was approaching its 10-year anniversary. But on the other hand, many were excited for something new, since the show had been around for almost a decade. Either way, on April 2nd, 2016, Dream Along with Mickey held a very emotional final performance, and over the next month, Disney began to prep for the new show. On June 17th, 2016, the new Mickey's Royal Friendship Fair opened to a fairly decent reception. It wasn't bad per se, it was just very different. It still featured the Fab Five in a charming song and dance style show, but all of the princesses were from modern movies now, which was a full 180 from Dream Along with Mickey, which only featured classic movies. Long story short, while people missed the timeless classic that was Dream Along with Mickey, a lot of people found the hip new Mickey's Royal Friendship Fair just as fun. Since 2016, Friendship Fair has been running daily, and while it is unknown whether or not it will come back after the COVID-19 situation is over, judging by how much entertainment is being cut at this time, I really hope it does, because it's a super fun midday spectacle. With all that said, let's move on to the design segment. I'm going to take this time to go scene by scene through this show, discussing each segment, so without wasting any time, let's get started. The show opens with a swell in the music as the announcer introduces the show. Dancers and a few of the Fab Five emerge onto the stage and begin to sing the main song of the show as they prepare for a party that Mickey is throwing that is to feature a big surprise. Being the diva that he is, Mickey is late to his own party and makes a big deal of finally showing up. Mickey then reveals that the surprise he's brought is that he has invited many special friends to dream along with the gang. But Donald is not satisfied with this surprise because he doesn't believe in dreams for some reason. Minnie then explains to him that everyone believes in dreams because that's the only way they'll ever come true. If everyone believes. Mickey then invites the audience to share their dreams with his friends, and the crowd obliges. Mickey then expresses to Donald that people do believe in dreams, and then invites the crowd to all dream together to give Donald a demonstration. And apparently, the crowd's collective dream was for Pyro to be shot off the roof of the castle, because that's exactly what happens. After this, Mickey's mysterious special guests arrive, revealed to be various princesses and princes. Snow White, Cinderella, and Aurora from Sleeping Beauty all emerge with their respective male counterparts and begin to dance around the stage. This goes on for a while before Minnie and Mickey join in the dancing, with Mickey stating that Minnie has always been a princess in his heart. I said that Minnie has always been a princess in his heart. You're supposed to awe at that. Ah, there you go. Anyway, after some more dancing, the princesses exit along with Minnie and Mickey, leaving Goofy and Donald on stage. Donald, still thoroughly unimpressed with this whole party, endures Goofy discussing his dreams of adventure. And then, just like that, Peter Pan appears. He summons a bunch of pirates and— Oh no, they've taken Wendy hostage and— I guess these are friendly pirates. Okay. Anyway, the pirates, joined by Wendy, Peter, Goofy, and Donald, all perform a dance number before transforming Donald into Captain Hook and Goofy into Mr. Smee. After this, the real Captain Hook and Mr. Smee appear and proceed to attack their doppelgangers. But Peter Pan foils their plans by taking on the one-handed Captain himself. Eventually, Pan is cornered by Hook, but lucky for the good guys, for some reason, Donald knows Hook's very specific foible. And even more luckily, Donald manages to pull a clock out of God knows where in order to scare off the evil pirate. Hook then proceeds to run around like an idiot before being taken down by the ensemble. After this, Maleficent appears, and she is quite upset that she hasn't been invited to Mickey's party. She then explains that she has dreams to share as well, and Minnie, for some reason, asks her to elaborate. So she explains that she plans to turn the Magic Kingdom, the place where dreams come true, into a place where nightmares come true. This leads the gang to cower in fear, with the exception of Donald, who stands up to the Pickle with Horns, telling her that his and his friend's dreams can defeat her. Mickey then instructs the audience to chant "Dreams come true" in order to fend off the evil fairy, and once again, more pyro is shot off the roof. Defeated, Maleficent retreats back to wherever she emerged from, declaring that Mickey hasn't seen the last of her. Insert phantasmic joke here. Mickey and the gang then explain to Donald that by believing in his dreams, he's managed to save the day and fend off the forces of evil. This leads into a big finale where the entire cast, minus the evil characters, take the stage and perform another dance number devoted to dreams. This all leads to a massive climax where more pyro is set off as Mickey and Minnie are lifted off the ground on a small platform, an effect left over from Cinderellabration. After this, a short curtain call is held to the tune of the song from the opening. And then the characters exit and the show ends. So that's Dream Along with Mickey. What do I think of it, you ask? Well, allow me to answer that in the conclusion. So, Dream Along with Mickey. What can I say about this show that hasn't been said before? Oh, I know, just about anything, because no one talks about this show for some reason. I love this show so much. It's heartfelt and sweet, and most importantly, timeless. I love Mickey's Royal Friendship Fair, too, and while it is heartfelt and sweet as well, it's not timeless. Sure, the three main movies featured in it were all semi-big hits, but I think in 10 to 20 years, it's gonna be really outdated. Dream Along with Mickey would still hold up, I think. Maybe there's a few changes here or there to the costumes or scripts you need to make, but overall, I think the show would have held up extremely well. I don't know why no one talks about this show. It really makes no sense to me. It certainly made researching this episode nearly impossible, but it also means that future generations of Disney fans may never know it existed. And while some shows in this company's history deserve to be forgotten, Dream Along with Mickey doesn't. Overall, I think replacing this show is fine, but I don't want it to be forgotten. The changing of this show really goes along with the new vision of the Magic Kingdom. Seriously, so much stuff changed entertainment-wise during this time, and now the park is a completely different place from when it was even just 4 years ago. It started with the conclusion of Celebrate a Dream Come True in 2014. Then, along with the loss of Dream Along with Mickey in 2016, we lost the Main Street Electrical Parade. And then, just a few months later, Celebrate the Magic ended in November, and then, most importantly in my mind, we lost Wishes in May of 2017. I'd argue that this collection of shows formed a cornucopia at the park that really set the tone, and it's a different place now that they're entirely new shows. Not bad at all. In fact, I'd argue that Happily Ever After and Once Upon a Time are better than their predecessors, but either way, what came before should not be forgotten. Change isn't necessarily a bad thing at all, but it's important to keep track of what came before. Anyway, about Dream Along with Mickey, it's fantastic. It's a wonderful show with an emotionally resonant message that really shows just how incredible Disney Entertainment can be. Thank you for watching this episode of Remember the Magic. If you enjoyed it, please consider liking the video and maybe even subscribing to my YouTube channel. There are a lot of videos coming out real soon you won't want to miss, so be sure to click the bell icon so you get notified when we upload a new video. And remember, the answers to where we are going often lie in our past. Have a great, big, beautiful day, and remember, tomorrow is just a dream away.